I think opening your eyes really deals with kind of a sense of self-worth, kind of living up to your own expectations. That's the kind of lyrical content there. I've been playing in bands for about 20 years, and it's just having that belief in yourself, or trying to maintain that belief in yourself, that hopefully one day you can get to the point where what you hoped and dreamed of is reality. And there's been a lot of roadblocks in there. And I think, as probably as human beings, we all strive for something better. Sometimes you have to stop and accept it, or realize that where you're at is a brilliant, great place, and you can be okay with that and find you're happy. I think for the longest time I've been searching for something, and maybe I haven't found it, but I always maybe had that in front of me the whole time.
This song, I was going through a big running phase, and I wanted a song I could run to. Not that I listen to my music over and over, but the whole point of this song was just pure energy. Let's take the listener from, if they're starting their work day, if they're in the gym, just to skyrocket the blood pressure.
Yeah, it's probably one of the most aggressive songs on the album. Really interesting drum parts, and I think it's going to be a fan favorite if they like.
It has probably my favorite solo on the record. Travis really freaking shines on that bridge.
Travis made the middle section for this song for me with just this insane, like, fast, and I think it's sweet picked, like, picking Madness, and then breaks out into this melody.
The solo in Open Your Eyes is actually one that I'm probably most proud of. That one, I'd say, is a mix of inspiration from Jeff Loomis, John Petrucci, and there's like a little Jason Richardson type part in there. That's one that Chris Clancy and I, like, we really tore it apart in the studio. The main ideas that were there in my demo version of it are still in there, but he helped me rewrite it and kind of reeled me in, because the original version of the solo was like unnecessarily shreddy. It just was just way over the top. And he took the parts that he felt like were unnecessary and then helped me rewrite. And the melodic parts is where he kind of came in.
With this one, the whole solo was just tech. And Travis was really cool, because it's hard to be in like such an established musician, and someone like me comes in and just says, hey, that's great, but let's rewrite most of it. It's hard, but Travis was like, oh, okay, cool, let's do it. Which is really nice to have someone so open-minded and so talented. And we put loads of melody in there, like we had these ideas, I'd hum an idea and he'd be like, oh cool, and he'd do his own thing with it, he'd go away, he'd come back, and then we ended up with solos, like kind of like ultra tech meets Arch Enemy or something. It's brilliant.
And I loved all the harmonies that we added in there, and I think the solo itself turned out to be, I'd say, probably the best one that I've ever done in my entire career.